Hello, this is Learning-Based Synthesis of Artificial Social Laws. My name is Ronen and my co-workers are Alexander Shleyfman and Erez Karpas. Three of us are from the Technion, and enjoy. So our research motivation in this work is to promote coordination. And coordination is a key to many promising technologies, such as autonomous cars or robot logistics. However, still, achieving coordination can be a challenge. The social law approach for achieving coordination is to restrict agents' behavior such that all conflicts are prevented. We use the multi-agent strips formalism in this work, where F is a set of predicates. Each agent has its own set of actions, AI. Capital I is the initial state, is a subset of F, and GI is the goal specification of agent I. So under this setting, each agent finds a plan offline and then executes it blindly. Thus, there are multiple possible outcomes in this very simple two agents two-on-two grid domain. One possible outcome is described on the left, and this joint plan does not contain conflicts. Another possible outcome is here on the right, where for some reason the second agent decides to go up and then down, and this joint plan contains conflict. So of course, even in this very simple two agent domain, coordination is required. As we said, a social law restricts agent behavior. This is possible in strips by removing, deleting certain actions. In our example, for instance, removing specific actions leads to basically building a virtual wall between the two agents, such that they can't interact with each other. And the resulted planning problem is the same planning problem without the specific actions that were deleted by the social law. We say that a social law is robust if it's restrictive enough to eliminate all conflicts, but permissive enough to allow agents to achieve their goal. So, for instance, with this wall, the coordination is perfect. Both of the agents can get to their goal and they can't interfere with each other. In 2017, Karpas et al. Proposed is robust algorithm that can verify whether a given social law is robust. It has two procedures. The first one, find conflict. It returns a plan that includes a conflict, of course, if such exists. The second procedure ensures that the agents can reach their goal. For instance, for this simple social law, the is robust algorithm will return that the social law is robust. Another work describes the social law synthesis problem, where it is required to find a robust social law for a given multi-agent problem. The proposed solution was performed by a search through the space of all possible social law, starting with an empty social law, meaning without any restrictions, and each step of the search we add another action restriction until we find a robust social law that is verified by is robust algorithm. Of course, each multi-agent problem is solved by a new search. And this raises a question: can we use past experience to improve future social synthesis? Or maybe can we use expert knowledge to improve social synthesis? And in this work, we try to demonstrate that the answer is yes. We can learn something and we can use expert knowledge or knowledge from past social synthesis instances. So in this work, our contribution is that we propose a learning-based approach to synthesize social laws. Of course, the predictive model is not perfect, so we use heuristic search to correct possible mistakes, and we also show that we beat the previous state of the art. Let's consider the following very simple machine learning scheme where we have some data, and of course we split it to test data and train data. We use the train data to train a model, and then we use the model to predict social laws for unseen multi-agent problems. There are a couple of challenges in this scheme. That the first one is that the data has a symbolic structure. All of the problems we handle are PDDL based problems, and we have to find another structure, a more compact structure, that so we can train modern machine learning models. Also, different multi-agent problems have different dimensions, more agents, more objects, and you have to find a model, a machine learning model, that is not sensitive to the different dimensions of the input. And finally, the predicted social laws are not guaranteed to be robust, so we have to come up with a process that fix and find the mistakes and fix them. We propose a three-phase method: train and predict, pre-processing, and search. In the train and predict phase, we train a GCN model, a graph convolutional neural network, to predict a social law for an unseen multi-agent problem. We represent the given multi-agent problem as graphs. Agents, actions, predicates are nodes in the graph, and the graph structure describes the nature of the problem. The output is node level classification on the action nodes, and it basically says what actions should I restrict, and the predicted social law is simply a set of actions. In the pre-processing phase, we remove easy to find errors from the predicted social law. And this is based on the fact that overly restrictive social laws are relatively easy to detect because they prevent agents from achieving their goal and make the social law unfeasible. So we propose two-step process to find the largest feasible social law. First, we check every individual single action restriction. And then we do some kind of a binary search after the largest possible and feasible social law, details in the paper. And we denote the resulted social law as L feasible, a subset of actions that needs to be restricted. And the final phase is search for a robust social law. We propose to do a better starting point to the search and insert the feasible social law, the predicted feasible social law to the open list, and then guide the search using the output of the GCN model. Again, details in the paper. Our empirical evaluation focus on measuring the procedure performance in terms of time and number of robust social laws solutions and model ability to generalize. We let the models learn only from small multi-agent problems. We test also the model sensitivity to noise and the model sensitivity to a small training set. So in terms of successful searches, we see that our best configuration solved 32 instances where the baseline is 16. Also, starting with the predicted social law helps because the modified open list configurations have solved more than the empty open list configurations. And also, the H-sum heuristic brings the best performance. In this figure, we see our model's performance with the different training set sizes. And we see that learning actually works and beats the baseline, and more data yields better results. There is also a very nice correlation between the number of solved problems to the balanced accuracy metric of the GCN, and also a little bit of noise can help as long as we keep it low. At this point, we want to thank you for your listening, and happy to answer any questions. Thank you.